Just wanted to show you the difference between a composting worm, which is one of these ones, the red wigglers, and your common regular earthworm that belongs in your garden. You don't want to put the earthworms into your worm bin because they actually like to really burrow down deep. They can sort of go right down to about 200 centimeters. They can dig right down. What they do is they feed off of the organic matter as well, but they take it right down beneath the surface of the soil, and that's what helps improve your soil, improve your aeration of your soil. Whereas your composting worms, they just like to live on top of the decaying matter. So these ones are more appropriate because they don't need that depth. Even though they can be living in your garden, I mean, mine, I've got a lot of those red wigglers just in my garden beds as well, just free ranging around. They come and go into the compost bins whenever they want, and quite often you will see a few earthworms in there if they've got access to the bottom of the composting bin, like my Dalek, that goes straight onto the ground. So you can see with these earthworms, they're actually quite transparent. So just having this close-up look at them, you can actually see the organic matter passing through the body of the earthworm. You can see it in little clumps there. That's, as it gets towards the back, that's the castings ready to be dispersed out into the garden. It's actually quite a fascinating thing to see. You can't really see it too well in the red wigglers, the compost bin worms, but you can see it with these particular types of earthworms. Yeah, so they're amazing little creatures. So having your earthworms that live naturally in the earth, and your composting worms that live in your compost bins or your worm farms, and they just do a tremendous job. And as long as we look after them and make sure their conditions are right, your population will definitely increase. And just the benefits of the earthworms in your garden is a really great sign that you're having a healthy soil. So that's how the earthworm gets its name, because it naturally just lives in the earth. It would be a little unnatural to take it out of the earth and just put it into a plastic container and let them live in there. It's just, it wouldn't be right for them, for their environment and what their purpose is in the garden. So when you do dig around in your garden, probably have a look and see what type of soil you have down. Just to know that you have lots of earthworms in your garden, so your sand, your silt and your clay make up a great loamy type soil environment for your worms. It doesn't dry out like beach sand would do, and it won't be so abrasive on their little bodies. So to improve that, you can actually just put your garden organic matter down on top of it, your leaves, dried leaves and mulches and stuff like that, or you can just put some compost on top of that area, and that will help sort of attract the earthworms there once that organic matter starts breaking down, and then the little worms can then start burrowing down and taking that organic matter down with them and start improving that area. It might take a while for it to do, but you know, it won't happen overnight, but it will happen. Just popping those ones back just under this bit of leaf matter and twigs and this, that and the other. All this material here is just what I used with the Ryobi crusher shredder, and I just had this down just had a bit of as a bit of a weed suppressant as well. But there's generally quite a lot of just worms under the surface here. This area is right next to my Dalek bin I've got in here, which everyone can remember. I've just making this my compost bin and a bit of a worm farm. There's lots of worms in there. The compost is actually getting almost ready to be sifted through and separate those worms out of it. That might be another job for give another couple of weeks, and it should all be broken down. Oh, we're back again. Oh, well, that was really enjoyable. I actually enjoyed being out there digging around in the garden. I didn't have to dig very far or for too long before I found some earthworms out there. Maybe if you find different types of earthworms to what I've shown you today, maybe leave a description in below there and let us know what country you're from. And it'd be interesting to find the different types of earthworms that people have in their countries. So if you like this kind of video, maybe you could give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel if you like this type of material. And we'll see you in the next video. Okay, bye.